Hello, everyone. I'm Yu Zehe. This is a joint work with some collaborators and my supervisor, Professor Guo Liangxing. Autonomous driving is the future and has the potential of revolutionizing transportation, mobility, and safety. Even though autonomous vehicles are equipped with a variety of sensors, the onboard sensors have limited field of view and can be obscured by surrounding objects, which limits vehicles' perception. This leads to a major challenge in the safety of autonomous driving. A promising paradigm is to leverage smart roadside infrastructure to assist autonomous vehicles' perception. An example of such infrastructure is smart lamppost. Here shows a picture of the smart lamppost testbed we deployed on CUHK campus. These smart lampposts are equipped with sensors, which usually have wider and almost unobscured view. They can help to extend the vehicle's sensing range and improve their sensing quality. A key enabling technology for such an infrastructure-assisted autonomous driving approach is the perception fusion between vehicles and infrastructures. In this work, we study the problem of aligning the 3D point clouds from vehicle and infrastructure. In other words, the point clouds from vehicle and infrastructure need to be aligned in the same coordinate system, which is referred to as vehicle infrastructure point cloud registration. We now use a real-world case study to motivate vehicle infrastructure point cloud registration. Here, two LiDARs are mounted on the vehicle and the roadside lamppost, respectively. Below are the vehicle's point cloud and the infrastructure's point cloud. Here, we show the point cloud registration results. The infrastructure point cloud is pink, and the vehicle point cloud is green. The results show that after aligning the two point clouds, the effective sensing range of the vehicle can be extended from about 38 meters to 65 meters. On vehicle perception tasks, such as object detection, can thus benefit from the extended perception field. In the second figure, two additional people and traffic sign 3 can be detected after registration. Besides, the registration increases the resolution of the original point cloud, as shown in the third figure, which makes objects to be detected more easily. Formally, vehicle infrastructure point cloud registration problem is defined as follows. Given the infrastructure point cloud and the vehicle point cloud, we need to find a transformation T that consists of a rotation matrix R and a translation vector T. This problem presents several major challenges. First, each point cloud frame contains massive points and needs to be processed in real time. Second, there exists a large perspective gap between vehicle and infrastructure point clouds, and the overlap between them is not only small, but also varies dynamically as the vehicle moves. To address the aforementioned challenges, we propose VII. Our core idea is to only focus on several carefully selected semantic objects and extract saliency points from them. By matching these saliency points, we can finally register vehicle and infrastructure point clouds. A key advantage of our approach is to allow vehicles and infrastructures to extract the semantic information from their point clouds independently, which reduces the compute overhead of vehicles. Next, I will introduce each module separately. We first segment points into instances with semantic labels and only extract four categories of semantic objects, including traffic signs, lane lines, curbs, and road. These objects are most static, distinctive, and common objects in traffic scenarios, thus are robust to dynamic sense and can be easily recognized. Then instances with regular shapes, such as traffic signs and lane lines, are used to extract saliency points. We then propose a novel algorithm to extract saliency points of each semantic instance. The pipeline is as follows. We first estimate the plane of the semantic object and the filter points that do not belong to the object. Then project 3D point cloud to 2D point cloud, which will further be splitted to a binary image. Finally, we leverage the prior that the selected semantic objects usually have regular geometries to fit the binary image into a regular primitive. Then we extract the vertices and center of the fitted primitive as saliency points and project them back to 3D. Ground is a unique and strong prior in traffic scenes. By exploiting the ground, we can obtain an estimation of the rotation matrix between the vehicle infrastructure point cloud pairs. Specifically, we use ground-related semantic objects, such as curbs and road, to estimate the normal vector and the direction vector of the road. By aligning the two vectors, we can get a rotation matrix, RG, which serves as a registration prior and will be used to speed up the registration module. The registration module takes the saliency points in both ends, as well as the rotation matrix, RG, and estimates the final transformation. This is the flowchart of the original RANSEC algorithm. We propose two heuristics to greatly accelerate the classic RANSEC algorithm. First, each saliency point has two labels, semantic label and primitive label. When picking point pairs, we only match two saliency points that have the same two labels, which narrows the search space of corresponding saliency points. Second, we quickly check whether an estimation is a valid one by comparing the similarity of the estimated rotation matrix R and RG. When the similarity is low, we terminate an iteration early to reduce unnecessary computation. For the system evaluation, we collect the first multi-view LiDAR point cloud dataset that contains both the vehicle's view and the infrastructure's view. The first dataset is collected based on an indoor autonomous driving testbed, and the second dataset is collected using the smart lamppost testbed we deployed on our campus. This table shows the summary of the two datasets. For the indoor dataset, we set up 89 simulated traffic scenarios and collected 445 vehicle infrastructure point cloud pairs. For the campus dataset, we collected 470 point cloud pairs, covering three rows with a total length of 1.12 kilometers. We first evaluate how much application-level perception improvement our approach can bring to autonomous vehicles using the real traffic dataset. We use two metrics to evaluate the application-level results. The first is effective sensing distance. It reflects how far a vehicle can see. The second is point cloud density. It reflects how clear a vehicle can see. The left figure shows that our approach significantly improves vehicle's effective sensing distance from around 30 meters to around 50 to 60 meters. The red figure shows that our approach improves the point cloud density by around 97%. It can also be seen from the figure that VII boosted the point cloud density even higher than that of the expensive LiDAR used in the public KT dataset. In summary, from the application level perspective, VII can enable significantly longer sensing range and a finer grained perception for autonomous vehicles. Next, we evaluate the performance of our system with other registration algorithms. We divide each of the datasets into two groups, an easy group and a hard group. The hard group contains point cloud pairs with a large rotation or a small overlap ratio. The rest of the point cloud pairs constitute the easy group. The details of the grouping are shown in this table. We will present performance evaluation by comparing with four baselines: ICP, NDT, SACIA, and FGR. We adopt the metrics relative rotation error and relative translational error to compare the performance with other baselines. The relative rotation error and the relative translational error measure the point cloud registration errors between the estimated transformation and the ground truth transformation. Besides, we define the registration result as a success when the translation error is below a predefined threshold. Here, we only show the experimental results on the campus dataset. The evaluation on the indoor dataset shows similar results and can be found in our paper. This table shows the average rotation error, translation error, the runtime, and the success rate. We can see that our approach achieves higher success rate and delivers a 5x improvement in accuracy and 2x speed up over other baselines. We now show the performance of silency point extractor, the key module of our approach. We compare our silency point extractor with three widely used 3D key point extraction algorithms: Harris 3D, ISS 3D, and Swift 3D. We will skip quantitative results here, which can be found in our paper. We visualize the key points extracted by the three baselines and our silency point extractor in this figure. The key points extracted by the baselines are scattered randomly in the scene, while the key points extracted by our approach are highly interpretable, as they are all geometric vertices or centers of the semantic objects. Here we show some registration results. The figure above shows a bird's-eye view of the registration results in the campus scene. We can see that VII achieves better registration results. The bottom left figure shows an example of the easy group. The bottom right figure shows an example of the hard group, where there is a large rotation and a small overlap between the LiDARs on vehicle and infrastructure. In conclusion, we present VII, a system that aligns vehicle infrastructure point cloud pairs at centimeter level accuracy in real time, which enables a broad range of on-vehicle autonomous driving applications. At the end of this presentation, I would like to thank my collaborators, Li Ma, Zhe Haojiang, Yi Tang, and my supervisor, Professor Guo Liangxing. Thanks for watching. Please refer to our paper and our lab website for more details. Thanks.